Okay, we will have a look at group tracks and folder tracks. And this is a bit simpler than the effects tracks that we had a look at in the previous video. Now, to demonstrate the group tracks first, I'm going to add another audio track. So we can go to Media, to Loops and Samples, and let's assume that I want to add another vocal track. So I'm going to look for vocal, and let's see, let's do some ad-libs here in the same key. So this was C-sharp major. Let me see if I can find something like that here. So you see that's always indicated. If you go to the left, then you see it also. So this is C-sharp. Okay, let's add this to our project. So then it will automatically create a new track for us. So let's put it together with the vocals. But there it is. Let's also color this. So I will color this also as vocals. So now we know these two are vocals. So we have the same color. If I wish, I can just copy this several times. It's easy to do. So you hover your mouse over the clip. Then you see this attachment point, this handler on the bottom right. And if you do then Alt on the keyboard and then select it with the mouse and drag it to the right, then it will automatically copy it several times. With Ctrl Z, you will undo an action in Cubase always. Because I forgot to do something. Because as I explained, we have to put this in the tempo of the project. So we first should select this audio event and click on musical mode. And now it is also in the tempo of 120 beats per minute. And now let's copy this again. You can also do Ctrl-C, Ctrl-V as you what you are used to. So you can select it, click on it, Ctrl-C, Ctrl-V, and then it will copy. You can drag it with the mouse to the position where you want. Or if your cursor was already at the correct position, Ctrl-C, V, there it is again. Cursor there. So now we have multiple copies. So now we have two vocal tracks. Just let's play them. I select solo, so that we only hear the vocal track, but not the drum and not the piano. So I select play. So it is still there. I will disable also mute the effects. So I still hear a delay. That was on the first vocal. I do edit and I disable the stereo delay. And now we hear two dry vocals. And if we want, we can open the mixer again in the lower zone. And have the ad-lib vocals, which we consider as backing vocals, maybe a little bit at a lower level. Let's play. Okay, this will do it for now. And what we are going to do now is to make a group track. So again, I do plus. And now I select group, stereo out, it goes to the stereo out, folder setup outside the folder, that's okay. And let's call this vocal group. Add track, and there it is. So we can give this another color if we want. So I always make it red, because I consider this as a so-called mixed bus, so just in group. And what I want to do now is that I want to group these two audio channels with the vocals together. So if I now, and what I want to do actually is that this audio, let me open this. So if you click on this symbol here, then it will show all the output. It will show the output of this particular audio track. And what you see is that this vocal track will directly go to the stereo out. And that is the same for the new vocals that we have added. So if you click on this one and you say edit, then you see that this new vocal with the ad-libs will also go to my stereo out. Now I want to change that. And the way that I always do this, there are multiple ways of doing this actually, is that I don't want that the vocals go to the stereo out. I want to that the vocals go to my group channel. So the VOC group, as we have called it. So I just click on it. And now you see that changing in this channel editor. So we have the vocals. Now it goes to the vocal group. And then the vocal group goes to the stereo out. And that was for the new vocals. So we are going to do the same for the vocals that we started with, the vocal phrases. So we click on edit. You see that it directly goes to the stereo out. And now we want to, we don't want to route it to the stereo out. We want to route this to the vocal group. So we click on it. And then now the vocals go to the vocal group and then to the stereo out. You see that it indicates three targets, but that is because we also sent it to our delay and reverb. So you can always check what the routing is of a particular audio track or of an instrument track. Okay, so now if we play, let's go to the mixer again in the lower zone. So we have our two vocals. Then we have a vocal group. That is this one that we just created. And then here we have the stereo out. Now let's play our clip. Kinda love it. Kinda crazy. Kinda stupid. So you see now that we also have a signal in the vocal group. So these vocals will go to the vocal group, and the vocal group will go to the stereo out, which are your speakers basically. So now I can reduce the level of the vocal group, so you see that the vocals keep playing, so they stay at the same level because I don't change it, I can increase the level, but because they go to the vocal group, and this is now set to a very low level, you hardly hear them. And now I can increase both of the vocals. So this is one advantage of using the in group channel, because now instead of having to move two faders to reduce the level of both audio tracks, I can now use a single fader. But there is now another thing that I can do, and you, of course, you can guess what it is. We can now also edit the vocal group. And now I can send or use plugins here again to process both vocals at the same time, or I can send this vocal group to our delay and to our reverb effects channel. I enable it. So now I have my group channel. And the group channel is now also sent to the delay and the reverb. So let's unmute this. Put them to zero for the time being. But let's go back to the, because now, so the vocals will go to the vocal group. And the vocal group will send to the delay and the reverb. So we don't need the sends of the vocals anymore. So we can disable it here, or we can just remove them actually. So we say no bus. So the individual audio tracks are no longer sent to the, and here we never added them. So the individual vocal is not sent to the effects channel, but instead it is first sent to the vocal group. And now the vocal group is sent to the stereo out, but it's also sent to the delay and the reverb. So if you have many vocals, then you don't need to send each individual audio track to your effect channels. You can just group the vocals into a vocal group and then send the vocal group to the effect channels. And score, of course, depends a little bit on what you want to do, but this is one way of proceeding. And now if we play again, now I can increase the delay. And you see that this gives the same effect. So now for the all the vocals that I have in my project, I can change the reverb. So if I now change the reverb, so that will be changed for both the main vocal and for the background vocal in the same amount. So if you don't want that, yeah, then of course you need to add the send channels on the individual audio track. So there are all kinds of configurations that you can make. But to remember, so if you have multiple vocals, or if you have multiple guitars or multiple drum parts, etc., then we can in principle group them together into a group. And then with one fader we can control the level of a complete group. And that is very convenient to do. And we can process the complete group. Okay, so that are the group channels. So let's close the lower zone. So the last thing then to explain in this video are the folder tracks. So what I will do now is I will say, okay, let's add plus a folder track. I have to give it a name. So let's put, I do a vocal, add track. Now I've created a vocal group, a vocal folder. And in principle, so I can give this a color again. Let's also make that yellow. Okay. Make it yellow. Vocals. So now it is yellow. And now I can select these, all the vocal tracks if I want. And just move them, drag them into the vocal folder. So there they are, and now I can close the folder and open it. So, and all the vocal tracks are then hidden if you close it. And that is especially convenient if you have larger projects with many tracks. Then you can just put them in different folders and open them if you need to edit a specific track. And you can do the same for the effects track. So let's add another folder, and we say, well, these are the effects. Add, let's give them a color again. And now I can select these two tracks and drag and drop them into this folder. So, and this kind of organizes then my project. Thank you.